So all four spots still up for grabs here. Now this match takes on Mara Asker and Rasmussen for Hoki Kobayashi. They're the semi-finals. And now the Chinese fans have got some local interest on court. Await the player's arrival.
Court one, men's doubles.
What are your thoughts on this one then, Steve?
I'm looking really forward to see this. I really have no idea how the internal strength is in these two pairs from the Chinese team. Interesting to watch.
We met once before, that was at the Indonesia Masters last year. Down in Wang, that one.
Pretty
comfortable.
Red, you'll be fine. You won the toss, and you'll be on my right. Okay, the receipt. So who's receiving me? Receiving and serving?
First China Open for Liang and Wang. I wasn't sure. Navi, they're playing at home in a major tournament for the first time. Chuanyi got into the first round of 2019. Yu Chen will tell you about shortly. Here is Yang Weikeng, who's from the south, Guangdong. 76 centimeters tall, excuse me. Special moment to be playing in the first China Open, I'm sure. Those are their results so far. Great results, really. And they're my team. Boga and Saito. Very happy with that. It's very good. Can pack a real punch. Chen is 93 centimeters tall in the capital of Beijing. Seventh in the world, he has been a former world number of Legion Wei back in the day. The most decorated of these players. This one is from the south, Fujian province, 189 centimeters tall. Very getting together start last year. They were pushed, weren't they, by Li Fengqi and Li Fengzhen. Chinese Taipei.
Ready to play.
The prop box as well. Our American umpire, ably assisted by Roberto Stomi Oscariano, the service judge from Indonesia. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right,
Wang Chang and Liang Weiqing, China. And on my left, Ao Shanyi and Liu Yuchen, China. Wang Chang to serve to Liu Yuchen. Love all. Play.
So in terms of the ends again, same rules apply, Steen, for this match?
With the drift?
Yeah.
Drift is consistent. The play as the players in white, Liang and Wang, a bit tougher job lifting. We're probably going to see very high lift if they have to lift. That's easier for Wu and Liu. But I doubt that any of the two pairs are looking to play defensively. Distinct front court players in Wang Chang here, putting that one away, and Liu Chen, the vastly experienced former member of the Twin Towers combination with Li Junhui, with Wu Shanyi. Easily be a match where the rallies are not necessarily amazing, because when you play compatriots, you know each other from practice. And you know which buttons to push, and you go so hard for it, because if you don't, then you're at a disadvantage.
Fault receiver.
Liu Chen called fault receiver.
He's pointing at the screen as well. He's still determined to look at the replay
to prove his point.
Let's see. If I have to be honest.
And that was his point as well, wasn't it? Just talking, going back to a point you made earlier about sort of internal matches from the same country. Chris Langridge, one of our fellow commentators, also a former doubles player himself, said that quite often it was the lower ranked pair that go into these internal ones that somehow. He felt when he played lower ranked pairs in these matches that they would have the upper hand.
Service ball called too high.
Because they just know how to get at them like no one else can.
That's true, but there's a story of famous golfer Jack Nicklaus, who was playing the Masters, and they were going into the final round. And he was like two shots after the leader.
Six.
And he was asked, So, Jack, do you think it could be an advantage being two shots behind? And the thinking behind that is that you're probably going to get nervous when you're leading, and you're not going to get nervous when you're behind. Just like when you are the lower ranked pair, you have everything to
gain. Nothing to lose, right? Yeah.
But Jack Nicklaus, he had a winning mindset. So his reply was, you know what? If I'm going to win the Masters, I'd rather be going out two shots ahead.
Yeah.
Go! 8-all.
All square here between these two. Last year, the Australian Open and the Indonesian Open. And he started to make a mark towards, as the year progressed, with Oshwani.
11-8 interval.
So it's Liang and Wang here who have the 3-point lead.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Very relaxed there, these two.
They are very frequent users of the HSBC bench there. They complained at the World Championships that the bench has been removed because that's not a World Tour tournament, and and there were no bench, so they were thinking about buying a used portable chair from the Photograph, the ones that they're using. And they're sitting courtside there. It was, of course, old jokes and fun. But they like to sit down and contemplate what to do next.
Which is not something you see that often.
Silver, no. 12, 9.
Ooh, Yu Chen is the most experienced of the four here. He's never won the China Open. Two semi-finals, 2017 and 2019.
Away
from repeating that, but he's trailing here with Oshwani. The same impact this year, Liu and Oh, have they? As opposed to 2022.
Oh! Take us over. 10.
Into the net.
Players super strong in the fast-paced flat game, so getting the other one to play from below the tape is what they want to do.
Oh.
put away by Liang.
Service over. 15-11.
And, not quite the same kind of year for you and O this year. One semi-final appearance in the Japan Open. And Indonesia Masters. Those are the two best performances of the year. It's gone a little long here. 3-point lead though for Liang and Wang. Win this first game at this end, and that'll be a bonus for them. Power of the shot, isn't it?
Yeah.
17-12. Down at a great height, Liu Yuchen. These two are very, very tall. Liu Yuchen and Wang Xuanyi.
Position there. 18. Young and 14. Wang, with Young at the backcourt, Wang at the front, and they're hard to handle.
Position my time for previously 1-3 lost 2.
16-18.
The third time they've ever faced Chinese opposition, 1-1 and lost 1. Not too many opportunities to meet compatriots. Easily put away by Wang. Within sight here of this first game.
Yeah, so far they made the most of playing with the drift.
Service over. 19,
there in white.
60.
Make sure that the court is completely dry. Newton not too pleased with it at the moment. And, you can't really blame him given what we've seen so far. 19-16. Four game points now for Liang and Wang. Saved by Luano. Still in the driver's seat, you feel. Yeah, men in white. Oh. Second one saved.
18-20.
Two game points left for Liang and Wang to take the lead here, which they do. Liang and Wang at this end with the drift, taking the lead here, 21-18 in game one. Now playing into the drift. So in theory, gives them a slight advantage, depending on how Luano play with the drift now in the second game.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Second game, love all. Play.
See how this second game goes. Remember, Liang and Wang are into the drift, so in theory, that makes it a little easier for them. Also, just depends on how Luano approach it. Saw how well Liang and Wang played the drift, fast attacks, making use of the conditions in that sense. Will Luano take a leaf out of their book?
One.
idea was there from Wang. Go down the line into that corner. Put away by Ousmane Yeen. Taking the lead here.
4-3.
Magic.
Silver. 4-all.
So in the first game, the pair of Liu and Oh had the lead until 4-2. Then it was Liang and Wang all the way after that.
Out. Service over.
It's a short serve. A little bit disappointing. Champion, of course, Liu Yuchen. He's with Liu Junhui. That's why, yeah, I was not sure as well.
Challenges called in.
That's why it is now being challenged. I wasn't sure myself, I think it's probably just in. And it is.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 7-5. Play.
Oh, that might have been going out. That certainly did go out. And that's why Liu Yuchen's looking at it. And he probably should have left that. And they are all level again, Liang and Wang.
7-all. Seven.
front. Liang and Wang retake the lead. Remember, they other ones now going into the drift. They can really push through their shots, and we know that they do like to do that. Increase that lead up to 10 now, 3 points.
10-7.
That one's gone all the way into the other court. The spectators telling them where the shuttle's at, but he's coming back into the court now.
8-10.
Wang went on a bit of a mission there. Fruitless one in the end. They are still up by two here, Liang and Wang. Liang and Wang have that lead. 11-9 here at the interval of game two. They've already taken the first game. See themselves in a pretty decent position for this match. First.
Service over, 10-12. Service over, 13-10.
This 3-point lead, this is a pretty decent position for Liang and Wang.
Over 11-13.
We haven't had much in terms of rallies, have we?
Service over
this match.
14-11.
Special.
Service over.
We know to expect them to put the pressure on.
Oh.
they're only a point behind. Reminder again, the only other time that they have met last year. The Indonesia Masters, the Istora Senai, another place with a pretty significant drift. Another one winning that actually fairly comfortably. You and O have drawn level here. A bit of pressure, Liang and Wang in front. 15-14. Good defending here from Liang and Wang. Going to win this point. Still going strong, but in the end, it's Liu and O who win it. Great rally. Kind of missing that for a while, haven't we?
15-all.
They would here with the drift. Let's see how these final stages go. Looking for them to lift as much as possible and let the conditions go in their favor. Couple of all action rallies here, both of which have ended in Liu and O's favour.
16-15.
They were looking to get Liu and O to lift as much as possible. And they now have the lead, 39 shots, the longest rally we've had. But remember, at this stage of the previous game, Liang and Wang had the lead and never gave that up. Quite a different here now in game two. They've had the lead since they were 9-8 up until now.
17-15.
And now, perhaps, facing a few problems. Liu and O in front. By two. Very, very well placed. Both players on the same side of the court, lots to be exploited. 3-point lead they have now, Liu and O, and 3 points is what they need to win this second game, take it to a third. Unless, of course, Liu and O won't bring up their sleeve, perhaps. 18.
In it.
key moment here. Megan Wang, the world number three pair, world number seven. Not necessarily had the greatest of years, Liu Enou. 19 wins out of 31 coming into this tournament. Much better for Liang and Wang. 33 wins out of 43.
Play.
Again. Just to make it 18 all, let's see. Oh, it's found its target. Into that corner, another great rally. Three. Excellent rallies. And they were under the cost for quite a bit there, Liang and Wang. And some very good defensive shots to keep it alive. Clear. Three in a row here for Liang and Wang. Now, can they go on and win this? Edged in front.
Quickly.
Oh, he's tying up his shoelaces. We told to hurry it up. Very, very tight this one. A bit like the first. Oh, that goes over the huge frame of Liu Yuchen. It's not an easy thing to do.
19 all.
Which way will this go? The drift. Now they have match point here. One match point for Liang and Wang. And they've done it again. Liang and Wang have won this all-China affair. In a very tight match. They played superbly well in the first. Liu Enou came storming back in the second. It was tight. Remember, they were 15-18 down. They've won six of the last 7 points. What a time to do that. Liang and Wang. And it's now two wins out of two against Liu Enou. These two continue their upward trajectory, getting into the semi-finals of their first ever China Open. Dropping it into that little space there in front of Oshuanyi. show. Liang Weikeng and Wang Cheng, the third seeds from China, beat their compatriots Liu Yuchen and Oshwani, the seventh seeds, 21-18, 21-19. They've done that in 39 minutes.